Ooh, I wonder what music's playing in those headphones. I think I'll have myself a listen. Huh. I can't hear anything. Wait, what? I can't hear with my nose? Are you sure? Ears? Okay, let me try. Oh, I understand. So I can only hear things with my ears. I guess that means we have to use a specific part of our body to use each of the five senses. But what are the five senses? And which body part is used for each one? Let's find out. Before we get started, let's talk about what the senses are. Senses are the way that our bodies take in information about the world around us. There are five senses: hearing, sight, taste, smell, and touch. But did you know our senses like to work together as a team? That means even if someone can't use one sense, they may have a superpower in another sense. We combine all the information our senses gather to understand what's happening in the world around us. So, thanks to your help, we already learned that ears are the part of the body that makes hearing possible. Some people use special tools like hearing aids or cochlear implants to help them hear sounds better. These tools are like magic helpers that make sounds clearer for them. Sounds can be loud, or sounds can be quiet. Sounds also give you clues to understand what's going on around you. If you are able to use your sense of hearing, listen carefully now and try to identify three different sounds you hear. You can even cup your ears like this to help you hear better. I heard all different types of animals, birds, elephants, and even a big cat. Based on the sounds, can you guess where all these animals are? That's right. It sounds like they're in the jungle. You can learn a lot using just your sense of hearing. Our next sense is sight. What body part do you think is used for sight? I'll give you a clue. That's right. Eyes are the part of the body that makes it possible to see. Some people wear glasses or contact lenses to help them see things better. If someone can't see at all or has trouble seeing, they might use special tools like books with bumpy letters called Braille, or a white cane to help them move safely around the world. Let's go to my living room and see what we can find. Don't forget your binoculars. As I look around my living room, I can see a tall red lamp, a big black TV, and two books sitting on the table. Sight helps us understand the world by letting us observe the colors, shapes, and sizes of objects around us, plus so much more. Sight is the sense that tells us what our world looks like. The next sense is my favorite, taste. Point to the part of the body that is used to taste. If you're pointing at your mouth, you are exactly right. The mouth, specifically the tongue, is the part of the body that makes it possible to taste. Taste can detect sour flavors, like a lemon, sweet flavors, like ice cream, salty flavors, like French fries. Is anyone else getting hungry? Our next sense is the one that the nose is used for. Huh. What sense do you think the nose is used for? Good guess. The nose is the part of the body that makes it possible to smell. The sense of smell provides another way to understand and interact with our surroundings. Imagine the smell of a beautiful flower, so fresh and calming. Now, imagine the smell of a skunk. Oh, yuck! The smell of a skunk is not calming or relaxing. Skunks actually use that bad smell to tell someone or something to get away. And I don't know about you, but that smell definitely makes me want to turn around and walk the other way. The final sense is one that, technically, the whole body can be used for. Any guesses? You got it. Touch. The whole body has the ability to feel or touch. However, humans mostly use their hands to touch. That's because humans are able to feel more with our hands, and our long fingers help us explore the world around us. Let me show you what I mean. I can feel that this object is, ooh, sharp. I could feel that this object is hard and a little rough. And I can feel that this object, Mia? Is that you? Without even seeing Mia, I could feel that it was her based on her shape, smooth texture, and cold metal body. See you later, Mia. Wow, scientists, we learned a lot about the five senses. Let's take a moment to review each one. I'm going to say one of the five senses, and then you're going to point to the body part used for that sense. Ready? Okay, here we go. First up is sight. Point to the body part used for sight. Very good. The eyes are used for sight. Next is taste. Good job. The mouth is used to taste. How about smell? You got it. The nose is used to smell. Next up is hearing. I see you pointing to your ears. Great job. And finally, touch. Exactly. Hands are the best, but not the only part of the body to touch with. Great job, scientists. Now you know that senses are the different ways our bodies gather information about the world around us. But did you know you rarely use only one sense at a time? Everywhere you go, your senses are turned on and taking in information. As a scientist, you'll continue to use all of the senses you have to explore, describe, and ask questions about the world around you. Great job today. See you next time, and remember, science is all around us. Hey, hey.